Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I will be showing you how to perform put or update operation in your REST API. So here I will be using Postman, Node.js and MongoDB to do this. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a code for all the connection to MongoDB, the schema of the database and the post operation over here. So I have done an entire video on this, all these connections and how to post data. So if you want to watch this video, you can just click on this icon or the card that is appearing above. You can watch that video and you can continue with the put operation. So if you don't want to watch, you can just continue watching this video. It's your choice. So first, let me give you a demo on how this post operation works. And then let's just go and code the update operation. First, let me just go to my terminal and type node main.js. So it's running now. So if I just now go to Postman, and it's slash post, I will put okay, I will change these things. I'll put it to 3, and if I just send, we're getting posted. And if I just now go to my MongoDB, the first I'll be getting this value over here. So really simple post operation. And now let's jump into our update. Okay, so first I will just go over here and I will put operation over here. So it's going to be like a very, very similar code, okay? But the difference is that here we will be pushing all the data in the request body itself. But in the put or the update operation, we will be getting that ID through the params, okay? Through this parameter, okay? I will also show that to you, okay? So first, let's begin with the code, okay? It's going to be app.put, okay? And next is our URL over here, okay? So it's going to be, I'll just put slash update slash. And next thing, as I told you earlier, we will be getting the ID in the form of a parameter from the URL itself. So it's going to be colon ID. So we will be, with the help of this ID, we will be updating the particular data. Okay. And it's going to be comma async, and the regular thing, it's going to be request comma response over here, and arrow function and a curly bracket. Okay. That's it. So next thing, we need to have access to this ID value. Okay. But here we use request.body to get the value. And here you will be using request.params, okay? So let me just put, let my updating ID, I'll just call it as UPID over here, equal to request.params. We will be having this params, which directly corresponds to this getting fetching value from this URL, dot ID. So this ID corresponds to this one over here. That's why I've given a colon, which means that we can access it through this params keyword. So it's going to be like this. So I'll just copy this. And I will just go to my Postman, and if I just go to put, okay, and instead of slash post, we'll be putting slash update, and here we'll pass some ID. Let's say it is going to be 1. And in the JSON, we will be not passing our ID, okay, because we are getting the ID from our URL itself. So we need to pass ID over here. So I will just remove this. We will be passing the name and email, which is to be updated, and we will be passing the ID of that particular name and email in the parameter, okay. Really simple, I guess. So now we need to also have this name and email value, right? So for that, what we will do is just copy this, paste it, and instead of this up ID, I will put update name, and instead of this params, it's going to be body, and for ID, it's going to be name, okay? So just say copy this, paste it over here, it's going to be up email, and here I will be putting email. And the really important thing over here is that here I'm using params and here I'm using body. So this is quite similar to the post operation where I have used body as well. So that I think the reason is obvious. This params corresponds to this URL and this corresponds to the request body. So that's why I am fetching the ID from the URL and I'm getting the name and email from the body. So that's the reason why I'm using params and body over here. So now let's just jump into the main update operation, okay? So for updating anything, we will be having like two steps, okay? The first one is going to be, we need to find that particular ID. We need to first check whether that particular data that we are trying to update is like initially present. And the second operation is obvious, just update it, okay? So these are the two things that everyone does. But we can do the two things with the help of a single function itself. The function name is find one and update, okay? So for that, first what you need to have is, you need to have the model name, okay? So this is the model that I have created over here. It's mon model, okay? So you need to have that model name. So just copy your model name and just come inside this function, paste it, dot, you need to have find one and update. So this is the function over here, just click it. So this will take like, I guess, four parameters or four arguments. Really, you need to be really careful over here. So the first argument is going to be the ID for which we want to update the data. So it's going to be just open curly bracket and just pass ID colon and up ID. Okay. So basically this ID corresponds to the value, this ID, okay, corresponds to this ID, and this up ID corresponds to the ID that we are passing as the parameter over here. Okay, I hope that made sense. And this is going to be the first parameter, and the next parameter is going to contain all the values that we want to change or update. So next thing is going to be, again open curly bracket, dollar set colon, open curly bracket, next thing is going to be name colon up name comma email colon up email. Okay, so name and email corresponds to the key present in this database, and this up name and up email, it's obvious, is the data that we are passing from our postman. Okay, this is going to be our second argument, and you have to be careful to just come out of it. Put a comma over here, and you're going to put new colon true. Okay, I will explain you to this why we are putting new colon at the end. Okay, so now just put a comma over here and open circular bracket. Here it's going to be error comma data. Okay, really simple. If any error is going to come, this error will catch that, and this is going to be our data. Okay, so after this, just arrow function and just open curly bracket. Okay, so if you can't view this, I will just so this is going to be like a continuation from that. You can just also type it. So I think now it's perfectly visible over here. So now we are just going to have a simple if condition, okay? And this function finds and updates, okay? So it's basically performing two operations. So now let's have two conditions, okay? Our first condition is going to be, here I am having data of ID 1, 2 and 3. So what if I go to postman and put 4, okay? Update slash 4. So this 4 isn't going to be present in our database itself. So in that case, our data value will be null. Okay, so for that we will do if data equal to null. Okay, that is our ID isn't present. Okay, we will just put response dot send. We can just put nothing found. Okay, and our second condition is going to be obvious. If our ID is present and the data is also present, in that case it will automatically update that particular value with the required name and email. So in that case we will be putting a else operation, and we will put response dot send our data. So we will be viewing this data in the postman. It will be coming over here. Okay, so that's the meaning for that. So now let's just run and test it out. Okay, I think we are pretty much done over here. Let's run and see it now. So I'm just saving it, and I'm just stopping it now and just restarting it again. So it's on port 3000. I will just go to my postman, and first I will check what are the IDs that are present. So 4 is not present, like as I told you earlier. So now I will just put update 4, and let my name be something. Okay, I will just put let 1111 be my name, and let it be my email. Okay, something. So I am putting 4. So we need to get respond dot send nothing found should be present coming inside the console over here. So I will just send it now. So as you can see, I'm getting nothing found, which is absolutely right. And we are having this B, okay, I will put A itself. So we are having this ID 1 and having name as A, email as A@A.com. So I will now just change this values, okay. So for that, really simple, just go over here and put 1, and I will just pass this 1 itself for all. So I will just send it, and I'm getting this as a response over here. The reason is this line is being sent. It automatically updates it and sends the response, the data over here, and we are getting this over in our postman. So now if I just go to my MongoDB, it will be the same, okay, but if I just refresh this, watch over here, just refresh it, I'll be having 111 over here. That's it, we have successfully performed our update operation. And another thing as I wanted to mention is that I told you I will explain you why we are putting this new true, right? So if I just put new as false, I'm putting this new as false, okay, and I'm just saving it. I'll just stop it. So we got the updated data, right? We got the updated data in our postman over here. So it was earlier A as the name and A at abc a.com something, which are with the ID 1, but we are getting the updated value in the console of our Postman. So what if we wanted the existing data over here? So in place of 111, we wanted A and we wanted A at A.com, the existing value that was present before our updation operation. So in that case, we will be putting new as false over here. So now let me just restart it. Node R put main. So same thing, it's running now. So now as you can see here, we are getting having this value, and I will just update the same thing. I will put one as the ID, and instead of all ones, I will put all twos over here, all twos over here as well. And now if I just send it, I will be getting the same data over here. So if I just send it now, so I'm getting the same data over here, but in my MongoDB database, if I just refresh it, it will be updated, but I'm still getting the old data. So I hope that made sense to you. If you put new equal to true over here, we will be getting the updated data as the response over here. And if you put new equal to false over here, we will be getting the data before updation, that is the old data or the previous data. Okay, I hope that that was clear to you. And now let me just put it to true. Okay, I'll just put it to true, and I will just stop this. And the final thing that we are left with, we didn't even use this error. Okay, it's really important you do error handling. So if I just put if error, and I will just have response dot send, I will just put error. Okay, and I will have a if block over, else block over here, and just close it and put this entire if else block within that else block. Okay, so if you are getting error, we will be getting only this as a response, and this won't be even executed. So now I hope this works. I will just save it, and I will just run it again, and I will just go over here. So I'll just put the same thing. I'll put three over here. So I'm putting name and email. You can just give a proper name, and I'm just doing with the numbers to get there. So we just write now. So I'm getting the updated one. And so how to get an error? Okay, so I need to get response.error over here. So let me try this way. Instead of one, I will put A. Okay, so I will just send it now. So I'm getting an error. Okay, so this is being sent because we have given the ID as a number, I guess. Okay, so as ID is a number, so we can't pass a character or a string over there. So that's it, I guess. We have successfully covered put operation by using Node.js and MongoDB, and I hope you would have found this video useful. I also run many other videos in C, C++, Java, Python, SQL queries, as well as 3D animation using Blender. So do check other videos of my channel, subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.